Hi, I'm Andrea, and in today's video I'm going to show you how you can get back the classic system configuration, also known as MsConfig for short, from earlier versions of Windows on Windows 8. So, let me show you. So, I'm on Windows 8 now. And I'm running Windows 8. And I'm going to show you how to get back the classic MsConfig, otherwise known as system configuration, that is in Windows 7 and Windows Vista and Windows XP. Now, why would I want to do this? Well, after you have installed the Windows XP or Windows NT4 Task Manager or the Windows 7 Task Manager on Windows 8, which I've got here. When you run system configuration on Windows 8, which is this, it's different from that of Windows 7 and Windows Vista and Windows XP. I mean, here is the same. It shows you all the boot options and the startup options and the services that are running. I mean, the startup options of how to start Windows. But when you want to, when you access the startup menu here, it doesn't tell you what programs are running at startup. The Windows 7 system configuration and Windows Vista and Windows XP system configuration shows you all of the programs here which are running at startup, and you can choose to enable or disable them. But when you use the system configuration here on Windows 8, it doesn't do that. Instead, you're directed to Open Task Manager, and you have to click this. But the problem is that the Windows XP Task Manager doesn't show you the startup programs, neither does the Windows 7 one, and neither does the Windows NT or Windows Vista one, because in those versions of Windows it's here. And if you've got the Windows 8 Task Manager, it's fine, because you just control them from the Windows 8 Task Manager. But I haven't. I've got the Windows XP Task Manager, so. And I want to access the startup programs menu so that I can choose to enable or disable the programs on startup. I mean, it's got here that I can open Action Center and various things, but I need access to the startup program. So, and I mean, other people who have installed the Windows 7 Task Manager on Windows 8, which you can do, or the Windows XP or NT4 one, obviously find the same problem. But what you can do is install the MsConfig from earlier versions of Windows, but the Windows 7 one, when I tried it on here, doesn't work. So I'm going to show you how to install the MsConfig or system configuration from the earlier versions of Windows, but it's the system configuration from Windows XP, because it seems to be working best on Windows 8. I mean, you can install the one from Windows ME, that works, but the Windows XP is the most recent one, so I'm going to show you how to be installing that. To install the system configuration from Windows XP on Windows 8, you need to first copy the program file, the .exe file, the MsConfig .exe, from a computer running Windows XP, or if you haven't got Windows XP on a computer, you can extract the program file from a Windows XP installation CD, and I've done a tutorial about this in a previous video. This is what the program file we need. We need this. MsConfig exe, which is this. This is the system configuration program file from Windows XP, and it can, if you've got a computer that's where you've got the operating system installed, a Windows XP operating system installed, it's not in the Windows System 32 folder on Windows XP, as it is on Windows 7 and 8 and Windows Vista. It's in a hidden folder in Windows on XP called PC Health, and there's a folder inside that. You can search for it on Windows Search in Windows XP and it'll bring it up, or just extract this from the Windows XP CD, and you can also extract the help file as well. Now, one word of warning. The Windows 8 system configuration is part of Windows. Now, do not, under any circumstances, delete the exe file, the Windows 8 system configuration, from Windows 8, because if you do, Windows will stop working. So it has to stay where it is. It has to be left where it is in System 32. And another problem is there's the Windows 8 system configuration program file is also called MsConfig. So what we have to do before we install it is to rename the program file. I'm going to call it MsConfig2 so it doesn't conflict. And what I'm going to do is copy this program file and paste it in my Windows System 32 folder right now on Windows 8. Well, you can run it from anywhere, but I'm going to put it in the System 32. And now there's one more thing we need to do before we run it. It's going to System 32 and we need to run the program as administrator, and I'll show you how to do this. So here is the Windows XP MsConfig system configuration, which I have just installed here, and I've renamed it MsConfig2 because this is the Windows 8 MsConfig, which is the Windows 8 system configuration. So we can't have two files of the same name because Windows won't accept it, because it will conflict, as I said before. So this is the Windows 8 one and this is the Windows XP one. But before we run it, what we've got to do is change the settings to run it as administrator, and I'll show you how. You click on the exe file. This is the Windows XP system configuration file. You click properties, click compatibility, and change settings for all users. And then select run the program as administrator. You need to make sure that this is ticked. You don't need to run it in compatibility mode, just run it in administrator. You must run this program as administrator or it will not work. And what I'm going to do is open it, see if it runs, and it does. Here are the boot options. This is the Windows XP system configuration. This is so you can edit the system files, but don't do that, or I wouldn't do that. And this is also for deleting and modifying files, but you don't need to do that either. And here is the services, just like the Windows 8 one. And here are our startup programs. So now we have our startup programs because we've got the classic system configuration. And you can send a shortcut to your desktop. and I'm going to rename this Classic System Configuration. And it runs, look. And there is my startup programs. And you can also run the one from Windows 8 as well. Here is the Windows 8 system configuration. So that still works. So this is the Windows 8 system configuration. So the Windows XP system configuration will run alongside the Windows 8 system configuration, or the Windows 8 MsConfig, as they call it for short. And if you want to change the boot options, it's probably best to go to your Windows 8 one, because this is the main program file. But because it doesn't have a startup, if you want to change your startup programs, you go to the Windows XP MsConfig, like this. And here are your startup programs, which you can enable or disable. I mean, there are other programs that you can install where you can control your startup programs. CCleaner is one, but the problem with CCleaner is that although you can enable and disable the programs, it also has the option to delete, which I think is dangerous, because if you delete some startup programs, it could affect the running of Windows. Whereas the system configuration is a safe way to enable or disable startup programs by ticking or unticking this, and you can control what runs at startup and what doesn't. And you can also launch it from the run command by typing msconfig 2. Let's see if this works. It should. It does. So there you have it. So you can get the classic system configuration on Windows 8, and here is how to do it, basically. But don't delete the Windows 8 system configuration, because is this, you cannot delete this, which is the Windows 8 one, which must stay on the system, because otherwise you'll have problems if you delete this. So that's got to stay where it is. But you can choose to either run the Windows 8 MsConfig or run the Windows XP one if you want to control your startup programs. And you've also got your classic task manager as well. It's also got a nice help file here that tells you how to run it, that I have installed from Windows XP. So there you have it. So yes, you can get back the classic system configuration from Windows XP on Windows 8, and you can manage your startup programs the same way that you have done on Windows 7 and previous versions of Windows. So that's it. I'm Andrea, and I hope you've enjoyed watching, and I hope that this tutorial has helped you. See you in the next video then. Bye.